The Philippine Agriculture Department also allaying concerns over damaged crops due to widespread flooding in the country. Undersecretary for Rice Industry Development, Leocadio Sebastian, says the crops are still in their early stages and can still be recovered. Sebastian adds the recent rains were also a big help to the country's agriculture sector as it elevated waters in dams that are crucial for irrigation.
Yung sa palayan kasi pagka katatanim pa lang, pwede pa yan makapag-recover pagka kahit na nabahayan. Basta hindi lang yung lubog ng mahigit 2 linggo. Yung masyadong matagal nang nakalubog, talagang mamamatay na yung palay. But kung yan malulubog lang ng mga 2-3 araw, makaka-recover pa siya. So yun ang ibig sabihin nun. At kung yun naman mga bagong tanim lang at na-wash out, pwede pa nating hapulin mag-replant. Ang bagyo naman meron ding kailangan din natin ng bagyo Huwag lang tumama sa atin. Kasi pagka walang bagyo, wala ring ulan, hindi rin maganda. Kaya yung dumating na bagyo, nakakatulong din na mapilapan yung ating mga dams para din naman sa ating pagtatanim pagdating ng El Nino, so yung mga irrigated areas natin.
The Philippine National Economic Development Authority says the damage caused by recent calamities is not that substantial. NEDA Chief Arsenio Balisaca notes, even though events are still unfolding, the size of the damage is not that big. This despite the country recording 5.4 billion pesos worth of agriculture and infrastructure damage caused by Typhoon Egay and the southwest monsoon.
So far, in the case of basic commodities like rice, we have adequate stocks. I think that a lot of the imports came in the first half of the year, and that I think allows us to have that buffer. In the meantime, I think that the impact on inflation is not going to be that much. But it's still, you know, as I said, the events are still unfolding, and the thing is, this is July, August, and so it's not really the harvest season in many parts of the country for the basic agricultural products. So and it's so I think that the damage is not that substantial, and so I do think that the impact on the overall national economy is that serious at this point.
Balisacan also expressing confidence government will hit the 2-4% inflation target by the end of this year, as well as the 6-7% growth for 2023.
2-4 is very manageable. I think it's still very achievable. Now, the inflation is not just about typhoons, you know. It's all about supply.
Yeah.
And so if you manage any shortfalls that come that arise out of this, you know, of this calamities, then there should be no unnecessary, especially long price, elevated prices. We will be happy if we hit the 6%, given the quite challenging headwinds in the external environment, particularly the slowdown in our trading partners. I think we need is an average of 5.9% for the last three quarters of the year to hit the 6% growth, the lower range, the lower point of the range. We have not given up.
The House of Representatives has received the proposed 5.7 trillion peso national budget for next year. Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman turned over the National Expenditure Program to Speaker Martin Romualdez this morning. The proposed budget is 9.8% higher than this year's budget. The Education Department got the highest allocation at 924 billion pesos. The Vice Governor of Lanao del Sur expressing dissatisfaction with government's efforts to rehabilitate Marawi. Muhammad Khalid Rakin Adyong says the administration should have already found shelter for families affected by the siege that gripped the city 6 years ago. His remark came after the Marawi Compensation Board started processing claims for victims of the Marawi siege. The board vows to fulfill its mandate to give compensation to families who lost residential and commercial properties in the five-month war, but it admits it needs more funding.
2,000 kataon na po yung inaccept namin ng mga claims. Yung 150 ng July 4 pa lang po, ang estimate po ng kanilang final or nire-request na kabayaran, no, yung kanilang application for claim ay 700 million. Annual po yung pondo. Yung pong amount, maaari po yan lumaki, depende po yan doon sa makikita ng Kongreso. Sana po, dahil kukulangin po talaga yan, ma-increase po next year sa 2024 para naman mabayaran natin substantially yung mga nag-file ng claim.
Search and rescue operations continue for a missing Cessna plane bound for Cagayan. The aircraft took off from Lawagan, Ilocos Norte, and was expected to land in Tuguegarao Tuesday. A pilot and a student pilot were on board the missing aircraft. The last recorded location of the plane was estimated around 40 kilometers from Tuguegarao.
Noong 12:16 po, umalis ng Lawag, magandang weather. Kaya lang, siyempre, nagbabago ho yan dahil maraming bundok dyan sa may Kawayan area na yan, sa Palanan, Isabela. Kaya yung mga piloto naman ay familiar naman doon sa area. Kaya hindi natin maintindihan ngayon kung what process. Actually, po, pag sigurado certified dyan sa 152 na test. Ano? At kompleto naman po yung mga documentation. Isa ho yung tinitingnan natin na informasyon na yung mga service record, pati yung piloto, yung weather, at yun nga po, yung kondisyon ng aeroplano ng lumikat. Kami naman po, ginagawa namin yung sa abot na ating makakaya at tulong-tulong yung ating mga government agencies para makita yung missing aircraft. And hopefully, nakaligtas naman po yung dalawang pasahero.
Well, Senator Risa Ontiveros welcomes the suspension of agriculture officials involved in an allegedly anomalous onion supply deal for Kadiwa stores, but she says the ombudsman should also go after high-ranking officials of the agency. See, the ombudsman imposed a six-month suspension without pay on Assistant Secretary Christine Evangelista and two other DOE officials. Also ordered suspended were officials of the government-owned Food Terminal Incorporated. They allegedly violated the procurement law when it chose a multi-purpose cooperative to supply onions for the Kadiwa project. The ombudsman also questioned an advance payment made to the cooperative despite doubtful deliveries. The Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board likely to approve a proposed rush hour rate for jeepneys and buses. Some transport groups have appealed to the board to come up with a measure that would help the sector deal with high oil prices. Now, under the scheme, 1 peso will be added to the base fare of jeepneys, while the base fare of city buses will increase by 2 pesos during peak commuting hours, which runs from 5 to 8 in the morning and from 4 to 8 in the evening, except for Sundays and holidays.
Mawawala sa driver ngayon mga 150 pesos a day. Na iyan ay pwede sa computation ko, may pang-almusal na ng kapetinapay, may pambigas na at saka itlog na mabibili. Yun ang nawala sa kita ng driver ngayon sa 350. And hindi natin ma-expect, baka next week tumaas na naman to.
The regulatory board also eyeing an alternative solution by distributing financial aid to affected operators.
In the event na kulang yung fuel subsidy, we may resort to granting the request but not probably as high as 1 peso. Depende po. Now, if the fuel subsidy is not available yet, then we may grant the request for a 1 peso increase. But this will be subject to a study which we are doing right now.